Hello friends, welcome to Wikipedia. As you know, we have already started with the Indian polity, and on the same series, today I'm going to take one topic from geography. On the similar lines like polity, geography also carry significant weightage in any particular exam that you consider in India, right? And when we talk about geography, mostly our focus is on the different processes that you are having existing on the surface of the earth, and also we discuss about the internal structure of the earth, what is happening inside the earth, that also some portion that falls in this the domain of this geography, and then obviously you know the atmospheric part which is surrounding your earth. So these are the broader areas which fall under the category of geography when you talk in terms of the subject matter, right? I have taken, see, for any kind of surface feature that exists on the surface of the earth, that surface structure, that is the shape of it and what kind of that surface structure is, that largely depends upon the internal structure of the earth. And obviously, those structures are also modified by the external processes, but internal, that means structure or internal processes of the earth play a significant role in the formation of those surface features that you have on the surface of the earth. So in this video, my focus will be more on the formation of those different landforms on the surface of the earth because of those internal processes. And in the next video, I'll be discussing with you different kinds of landform. For example, you're having mountains. So across the world, what are the different kinds of mountains? And how they are formed, whether they are volcanic or whether they are like of fold in nature and something that way. Same way plateaus and different kinds of feature. So let us start with this topic. And as I mentioned to you, we are going to discuss about the major landforms of the earth, but our focus is going to be more on the formation of those landforms on the surface of the earth because of the internal processes that exist inside the earth. Okay. So as you know, on the surface of the earth, there are different kinds of landforms that exist, and you already know about them. For example, you are having hills, you are having mountains, you are having plateaus, you are having valleys, you are having like plains. So these are the different surface features that exist on the surface of the earth. For example, if I say, what is this? So obviously, you know, this is a kind of valley that has been created by the river, right? If I ask you, what is this? So obviously, you know, this is the plain area. So this is one of the features. So this is a feature here. This is another feature. If I ask you, what is this? This, you will say, this is the plateau portion. So even though we are going to discuss the different, these, all these landforms differently and how they are formed and across the world, what are the names of different kind of these features? For example, if I ask you, what is this? Then you will say, obviously, this is a kind of a gorge. Right, and if you ask, this is a mountain. So these are the some of the major landforms that exist on the surface of the earth, right? And there are two basically major processes which basically creates these landforms, right? One is, as I mentioned at the very beginning, is the internal processes inside that exists inside the surface of the earth, right? The other one is the external processes, right? So these two processes we are going to discuss separately, but our focus is going to be more on the internal processes in this particular video. Okay, so internal processes kaun se hogi? Caused by what these processes do, basically. As I said, something that is happening inside the earth surface. So what those processes can do? Either they can uplift the surface or it can sink the surface. So these are the two major impact that you're going to have on the surface of the earth because of the some kind of internal activity that is existing inside the earth surface. Okay, so that is why it is mentioned upliftment or sinking, right? These particular processes will cause on the surface of the earth at many places, and those places we are going to discuss, I will discuss with you. Now the second process is, once let us say these landforms have been there, not once they have been formed or they are already in the process of forming also, right? That activity continues. So, and then the second process that comes into picture is the external processes. So external processes kya hua? Jaise, for example, let us say I am having a mountain formation hogi. And let us say that is because of the internal processes that exist in the inside the surface of a surface. Now that structure of that mountain, shape of that mountain may be changed over a period of time by the different processes that exist on the surface of the earth. For example, that means external processes. For example, wind. when wind blows at a high speed, then obviously erosion of that particular mountain or hill or any other surface may take place. Rainfall, when rain hits those areas, then rainfall can modify those processes. Like you are having rivers, rivers can also modify those particular mountains. This is one of the feature that I am discussing, right? So that way, these are the different kinds of processes, external processes on the surface of Earth that can modify, like aapka snowfall hua, ice hai, that can also modify that. So these are the different kinds of processes that can also modify the surface of the Earth or the feature that exists on the surface of the Earth. So external processes causes what could be, either they will cause erosion, or that means continuous erosion ho sakta hai, rebuilding of the Earth surface by different processes. For example, erosion ka matlab hai erode hona, that is removal of the material from one place, right? Just see, have a look over here. Erosion is the withering away of the Earth's surface. Withering away matlab carrying away of the material from one location, right? The area from where that material has been taken away, we call that erosion has taken place. So we call it as a wearing away, we bol sakte hum, of that erosion. So erosion kya karega? Erosion obviously is going to remove the material from one location. Then another process, erosion could be in different forms. For example, a pictorial view aapko diya hai, all this. For example, yahan par erosion ho raha hai. So over a period of time, basically it will modify that area. Erosion ho raha hai, area may get modified. For example, same way over here. So the erosion process can act in different way. River erosion ho sakta hai, wind erosion ho sakta hai, aapka ice ke through erosion ho sakta hai, and all these processes, right? Then another feature that may get created because of this external process is called as deposition. Yahan par rebuilding. Rebuilding matlab dobara ek aur naya structure aapne taiyar kar diya, naya surface taiyar kar diya. Surface to wahi hai, but new kind of feature you got created on the surface of the earth because of this particular rebuilding activity, right? For example, just have a look. Ye jo yahan par deposition ka example diya hai, I think you can visualize it very easily. If I ask you, what is this? You will say this is a delta. We are going to discuss the different kinds of delta, prominent delta from your exam point of view across the world as well as in India also. But simply, when a river is going to meet a sea, or a, let us say ocean, so at the end of its course, yahan pe apna wo jahan par it is going to discharge its water, then whatever the sediments that it brings with it, whatever the different materials, heavy material that it brings with it, it is going to spread it in that particular area. So kya hua? The feature yahan par tayar ki hua, we call it as a delta. So ye kya hai? Depositional activity hai. This river brought some material from some another location and it is spreading it away or depositing in some another location. So this is the deposition, rebuilding activity that may take place. So these activities, erosion and depositional activities, these are the prominent activities that takes place on the surface of the earth, which can modify the surface features, right? So, we are going to discuss them separately, but now let me just discuss with you. Deposition, I already explained you, is a rebuilding process in which sediments, material that you have brought, are laid down, deposited in a new place, right? Erosion and deposition is carried out by running water, ice, wind, right? Different processes that exist on the surface of the earth. Now, let us move on toward the, as I said, in this video, my focus is going to be on the internal processes, how they are going to create or modify the surface of the earth, right? So let's move on to those processes, right? Before that, we discussed that what are those processes that modify, that means internal processes that create the those features on the surface of the earth. First, you need to understand a little bit about the internal structure of the earth. In this video, I will not go in very detail about the internal structure, but I will just discuss the basic details with you that are required for us to understand how those features got created on the surface of the earth. Those features mean, for example, you are having plateaus, you are having valleys, you are having mountains, and etc. So how those got created because of internal activity that takes place inside the earth. And that internal activity ke liye first I need to understand the structure, internal structure of the earth. So highly idealized internal structure of the earth, a layering system layering in the form of a layering, we can understand. For example, predominantly humne kiya us circle ko, aap, as you know, this is a sphere, humne teen prominent parts mein divide kiya. We have divided the whole internal structure into three main parts. The most internal structure, that means this is a sphere, as you know, this is the innermost part we call this as a inner core. Basically, one is core. Outermost part, let me just start from here. Outermost portion, we call it as a crust. And it is very thin and hard. Then as we move inside towards the center of the earth, the next portion that will come into picture will be this red portion. We call it as a mantle. Then the innermost portion, we call it as a this and this combined together, we call it as a core. I hope you are already having idea of little idea about this. And core again, we divide into two parts. That means the inner core, innermost part, and this is the outer core. So this is how. So that means we will call it as a crust, mantle, and then you are having a core, right? Just have a look over here. This is how we can think of it. So here we are having the same thing. That means you are having crust, mantle, outer core, and then inner core. Now, this is how something we, if you want to study, then pictorially we can represent this way. As I told you, the outermost portion is the crust. Then you are having mantle. Then you are having this core. Now, two, 3 points that you need to know. Roughly, what is the thickness of the topmost portion? If you're calling it as a crust. So this crust portion, basically, if you just see, it can vary up to 100 kilometers, right? That means thickness can vary. In some places, it could be 5 kilometer. In some places, it could be 50 kilometer. In some places, it could go up to 100 kilometers. That could be the thickness when you move from top to bottom towards the inside of the earth. As you move inside, right, as you go from this point to, let us say, this point, that is 2900 kilometer inside the earth, then your that portion, that is below crust, you are going to have this much. Up to this point, up to 2900 kilometer, you are going to have the mantle portion. So, ye jo figures hain, they are important for you. You should be very clear ki, okay, crust kahan se kahan tak, it can vary from up to what depth. And then, beyond that depth, up to what kilometers, radially, inside the earth, you are going to have the mantle portion. Then we call it as a 2900 kilometer. As you move again, radially inside towards the center of the earth, then as you go deep 5155 kilometers, then itna portion where that means you are going to have the outer core portion, right? And as you move inside from this, then basically you are at the center of the earth, and the center of the earth is going to be almost 6371 kilometers from the earth's surface, right? So ye jo division hai from where your inner core, as I told you, inner core, inner or outer core ke beech boundary jo from the top of the surface of the earth, at what kilometer is going to be there? This figure you should almost know, right? At what is the center, what is the radius of the earth, you should know. And where you're going to have the core portion starting from, the where the mantle portion will be separating, not, it is not separating as such, but that means the way we have made the division, that where is that particular core portion that is going to start when we move radially inward, right? So this is one thing that you, in terms of factual information, if you talk. Second point that you need to note off from the exam point of view is the, what is the structure? That means, is it solid, liquid, or something? Right? Just have a look over here. As you can just have a look, inner core is solid, whereas outer core is liquid. So, yeah, factual information you should know. Why it is liquid, why it is solid, that is not, does not fall in the scope of your like exam, but you should know this. Why this is solid, then you are having liquid. And again, as you come to the mantle, mantle is solid. Mostly, major portion is going to be the solid, right? We will discuss about asthenosphere, discuss karenge hum over here. And then obviously, as you know, crust is again rigid and solid. So solid, liquid, then again solid, and then again it is, crust is going to be solid, right? So ye aapko ek aur, one more that is important information that you need to know. Now, after the gross, that means overall division in terms of crust, mantle, and then core. And core mein bhi humne baat kar di, outer core and inner core. Let us now discuss some more naming that has been. Ab hum thoda sa detail mein jayenge, where you're going to know some kind of different namings that you need to know about the internal structure of the earth. Right? Okay. Again, further division, I hope you will have a look over here. We will try to understand from this in a very simplified way. Then same thing I will show you over here also. Right? For example, as I mentioned over here to you, that topmost layer, वी कॉल इट एज ए क्रस्ट। तो जो क्रस्ट आपको दिख रही है वो दिस इज दिस पोर्शन, दिस इज द क्रस्ट, टॉप मोस्ट लेयर इज क्रस्ट। नेक्स्ट पोर्शन दैट आई टोल्ड यू इज मेंटल। अब मेंटल को भी हमने फर्दर क्या डिवाइड किया है, वी हैव डिवाइडेड द मेंटल इनटू अपर मेंटल एंड लोअर मेंटल, राइट। सो जस्ट हैव अ लुक फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट वेयर योर क्रस्ट फिनिश्ड, जहां पर आपका क्रस्ट खत्म हुई, एंड ध्यान रहे, जस्ट कीप इट इन माइंड, दीज आर नॉट क्लियर स्ट्रेट लाइंस, देयर विल बी वेरिएशन, राइट। इट इज नॉट वेरी क्लियर, इट्स नॉट दैट सिंपल, बट pictorially, to represent it pictorially, we need to show this way only, right? Variation can take place. Like, you will not say that exactly 2900 kilometer radius pe hi aapka jo hai wo clear division hoga. No, it may somewhere, it may take as 2800 kilometer and somewhere it may be go at 3000 kilometers. So that variation is possible. But anyhow, now, just go to the next portion, as I mentioned. First one is a crust, and then second one portion, as I mentioned, is mental. So mental, as I said, is again divided into two parts, that is upper mental and lower mental. Just have a look. This portion from here to here, we call it as a upper mental, and from here to here, we are having lower mental. So this total mental, again, we have further divided into upper mental and lower mental. Basically, this division, these divisions are basically based upon the structure of the rocks. Internally, right, internal structure of my variations that exists, based upon that we have divided that. And then, as you know, this is the outer core, clearly visible over here, and this is the inner core. So again, what we did is mental ko bhi further humne divide kar diya into two parts, that is the upper mental and lower mental. Now I had told you that the mental portion, this complete portion, is solid in general, right? So when I said this is solid, now as we move upward, like as this mental portion, this the top portion of the mental, this is total mental from top to bottom, yahan se leke yahan tak, right? The top portion of the mental, which basically this portion is rigid and solid, right? Total mental, as I said, is in general solid, but this portion of top portion is rigid as well as solid. Solid तो है ही और rigid भी है. It's something like crust. जैसे crust है आपकी rigid, it is rigid as well as solid. Similar kind of structure that it is going to have at that is which portion? The topmost portion of this particular mantle, this portion. That is why combined together crust, because crust is also rigid and solid, and this portion is also rigid and solid. That is the top portion of this mantle is also rigid and solid. Combined together, we call it as a lithosphere. Clear? So lithosphere kya hai? Lithosphere includes your crust as well as the top portion of the mantle, which is hard, rigid, and solid. Isko humne lithosphere bol diya. As you move little down, iske niche jaise hi hum, now we are talking in mantle mein hi hum, right? So mantle mein thoda sa niche jaoge, you are going to have this portion. This portion is not solid. It's something kind of semi-solid. Na to liquid hai, it's not either liquid, neither solid. Solid hai, but because it is a plastic solid, something it can deform easily. Right? So it is not rigid solid. This upper layer was rigid solid of the mantle. But iske beneath wali choti si layer hai, that is not rigid solid. It is solid, but it is something you can say it is... It can easily deform, right? So this portion, which can easily deform compared to other these top or bottom, isko humne naam de diya hai asthenosphere. Asthenosphere is going to play a very significant role that I will discuss with you in the formation of the different features on the surface of the earth, right? So dhyan rahe ki asthenosphere kya hai? It's a solid, but it can easily deform over a period of time. Right. So, and then as you move down, then again, it is the lower mental, jo bhi hai aapka, this remaining portion kya hai aapka, this is mental only, right? Mental basically started from here, upper division jo hai humne thoda sa alag kar diye, ek portion jo hai, we clubbed it with the crust and we call it a lithosphere, a small portion below it is called as a asthenosphere. As we said, it is something kind of like solid, but it can easily deform, semi-solid kind of thing, right? Highly viscous, that you can say, and then remaining portion, जो है इसके बाद एस्थेनोस्फियर के नीचे वाला जो पोर्शन है, देयर इज वन मोर नेम कॉल्ड एज मेसोस्फियर. sometimes based upon this structure of these rocks, we also call this portion as a pyrosphere. Right? So ये ध्यान रहे आपको. तो mesosphere कौन सा हुआ? Asthenosphere के portion के नीचे. Below the asthenosphere, the portion of the mantle below the asthenosphere is called as mesosphere. If I ask you, is asthenosphere part of mantle? Obviously, you're going to say. The question can be framed in any way. That asthenosphere is part of what? You will say simply it is a part of mantle only. Right? So, mesosphere below the asthenosphere till the outer core. This portion is called as mesosphere. As you go below the this portion, you know, this is already outer core and inner core. We call it as a barysphere. Right? So, these different names you should know, and these namings have been given by like different researchers. Kind of, you will say lithosphere, asthenosphere, mesosphere, barysphere. Some kind of like a particular researcher, famous researcher may have given, right? And some another researcher may have further divided these kind of in different layers and all that. But from exam point of view, significant names, you know, we should be clear about. Right? So, same thing I am going to repeat over here so that it remains in a like a in your mind, it goes very well. So, for example, as you know, if you just see, this is the ocean. Blue color is the ocean, and this portion is the hills, and maybe like the remaining portion of the earth, which is continent or land landmass, you can say. Now, this portion below this whole portion, if I ask you, what is this? This is simply crust. That means we had said that crust thickness can vary from what? 0 to 100, right? Very thin to, that means up to 100 kilometer, more appropriately. Up to 100 kilometer, the crust thickness can vary. Now just have a look. This is the crust thickness. So as I have told you, thickness of the crust can vary. For that is equally applicable for any other layer also. So this crust thickness can vary. And if you just have a look from here, the thickness of the crust under the ocean is thin compared to the thickness of the crust below the this land surface or continents, you can say, landmass, right? So, ye aapko pata hona chahiye ki ocean, the reason basically is that the crust below that oceans is denser, right? And that is why thickness jo iski kya ho gayi hai, kam ho gayi hai, right? Because you are having weight also upper over there, and therefore this is, you can say, thinner. So, the factual information that you should know is that the crust thickness of the crust below the ocean is thinner than the thickness of the crust below the landmass continents or continents, right? What is the next portion below the crust? As we discussed, you will start with the uske baad jo it is going to be start the mantle start ho jayega, but mantle ka wo upper portion which is what? Solid and rigid. Ye wala portion. This portion. Sorry. This portion. This portion, okay. So this is the portion of the mantle, topmost portion of the mantle, but it is a hard, rigid, and solid, and combined together. That is why, if you see, combined together, this we have called it as a lithosphere. Then, as you go below the lithosphere, you are having the asthenosphere, which is again the part of the mantle. But as we said, this is highly viscous and solid, but it can deform easily. As you go below, we said this was the mesosphere. We called it as a mesosphere or pyrosphere also. And as we go down, then you are having this outer core and inner core. You are going to have the barysphere. Now, so in terms of structure, let me just refer it, but we will not go into detail. Okay. So some names have been mentioned over here. For example, Sima, Naif, Sial. These stands for the kind of minerals or elements that are dominant in those particular crusts. For example, if I ask you which is the dominant elements which are in barysphere, which are the dominant elements? It is Naif. Naif here stands for, Ni stands for nickel and Fe stands for iron. Right? So if I ask you, so you should be very clear that is a question can be framed that in barysphere is dominant in what kind of like materials or what kind of elements, and you will be able to say that is nickel and iron. Knife, Ni, nickel, Fe, iron. Same way, if I ask you which kind of elements are dominant in the mesosphere rocks, then you are going to say that is the Sima, right? Sima, Si stand for silicon, Ma stand for magnesium. Same way, if you come to the lithosphere or the, particularly the crust, then crust may, if you can just have a look, it is a Cr, that is Cl stands for silicon and aluminium, right? So as you move towards the boundaries, for example, crust se jaise hi aap towards the as you move towards the mantle, then somewhere here you are going to have a mixed proportion of this, right? Different kuch portion Cl rahega, kuch portion jo hai sima ho sakta. That way, same way transition zone always going to exist. But categorically, if you want to define, then you will say particularly the crust, you will say it is going to be the Cl, silicon aluminium. If you say mesosphere or mantle more specifically, then we are going to a dominant material will be like sima, that is silicon and magnesium. And when we go to the core, then dominant the elements that they are going to be what is nickel and iron. So I hope you understood now the different categorization or different names. You should be very clear about this, because straightforward questions aapse puche jayenge. Mantle kahan par aapka खत्म होता है, एट व्हाट डेप्थ शुरू होता है, मेसोस्फीयर कौन सा पोर्शन है, एस्थेनोस्फीयर इज विच पोर्शन, लिथोस्फीयर कौन सा पोर्शन, बेरिस्फीयर कौन सा है, इनर कोर एंड आउटर कोर की बाउंड्री एट व्हाट डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम द टॉप लेटर से कितने पे है, रेडियस कितना है, ऑल दीज आर द पोटेंशियल क्वेश्चंस, राइट? व्हाट इज द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ लिथोस्फीयर, लिथोस्फीयर कंपोज्ड ऑफ व्हाट, क्रस्ट एंड अपर मोस्ट सॉलिड मेंटल, समथिंग दैट वे, राइट? सो ये हमारे लिए इंपॉर्टेंट था जानना. लेट मी जस्ट नाउ दिस summarize, or let me just whatever I have written over here, so let me just explain, even though I have already discussed with you, right? So Earth's lithosphere include what? Crust and uppermost mantle, we have already discussed, which constitute the hard and rigid outer layers of the Earth. Lithosphere is subdivided into the tectonic plates. Ye jo part hai ki lithosphere jo we have divided into the different tectonic plates. Now after this I will discuss with you, because based upon this we are going to study about the generation of the landforms, right? नेक्स्ट इज द मेसोस्फीयर. मेसोस्फीयर जियोलॉजी में जो है, जियोलॉजी एज यू नो इज द स्टडी ऑफ द इंटरनल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द अर्थ. ज्योग्राफी में यू स्टडी सम पोर्शन ऑफ द, इवन दो ओवरऑल आइडिया यू ट्राई टू गेट, बट जियोलॉजी में डिटेल में वेन यू डिस्कस इन डिटेल ऑल द थिंग्स इंटरनली, इंटरनल अबाउट द इंटरनल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ और इंटरनल प्रोसेसिस ऑफ द अर्थ, दैट फॉल्स अंडर द कैटेगरी ऑफ जियोलॉजी, राइट? रेफर्स द पार्ट ऑफ द अर्थ मेंटल बिलो द लिथोस्फियर एंड एस्थेनोस्फियर. लिथोस्फीयर और एस्थेनोस्फीयर से नीचे वाला पोर्शन जो है ये, इसके एस्थेनोस्फीयर से नीचे वाला पोर्शन, एंड बिटवीन दिस, दिस इज मेसोस्फीयर, राइट? एंड देन लिथोस्फीयर बेसिकली कैन डिफॉर्म, राइट? इवन दो इट्स ए रिजिड एंड एज यू से इट्स रिजिड हार्ड एंड सो ओवर पीरियड ऑफ टाइम व्हेन वी कंसीडर इट इन ए लाइक लॉन्गर होराइजन जियोलॉजिकल टाइम पीरियड में इफ यू कंसिडर इन मिलियंस ऑफ इयर्स एंड ऑल दैट, राइट? So in that lakhs or millions of years, in that case, this particular crust, or you can say lithosphere combined together, can deform elastically as well as brittle fracture, right? So for example, this is a straight, let us say, crust portion. So if I apply a force slowly, 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 so it can deform, right? Shape may get changed, but it can also fracture in many points, right? So one part is that lithosphere basically over a period of time can definitely elastically, as well as it can deform elastically as well as through brittle failure. Whereas when we talk about the asthenosphere, as I mentioned, asthenosphere will behave like a highly viscous material, right? It is a like made up of rocks only, but since temperature is relatively more, so the rocks can over a period of time can deform easily compared to the portion above it and the portion below it. Right. So that is why this particular asthenosphere portion becomes important for us when we talk in terms of different features on the surface of the earth. So asthenosphere deforms viscously, highly viscous state pe hai, right? Accommodates strain through plastic deformation, right? That means plastically ye deform hoga, shape change hogi iski over a period of time as you will apply force, or rather internal forces, when the internal forces will act. Okay, so in addition to it, let me just discuss with you some kind of discontinuities which have been defined, because this could be a potential question from the exam point of view. So these are some of the discontinuities which have been mentioned, right? Even though we have mentioned different divisions, like different like investigators may have given these divisions, on the similar lines, when we talk about these discontinuities which have been mentioned, these discontinuities have been given based upon the seismic analysis or seismic data or analysis of the seismic activity inside the earth surface, right? So when the studies have been done related to the earthquake generation and all that, so usse related jo studies hain or activities hain, we call it as a seismic activities. So as you know, okay, little idea you may be having, for example, when some kind of earthquake take place, we know that there is an epicenter inside the surface. From that particular center, from there where that particular earthquake originated, some kind of vibrations and waves will be generated. Then when those waves travel inside the earth through different layer or through the earth structure, so there comes some kind of when they travel through that internal, that means internally travel, then they get deflected or diffracted in some locations, because the rock structure inside those particular layers or inside the in those particular areas may differ. So because of that difference in the structure inside the earth, there we find that these waves basically show some kind of variations, and based upon those variations that these kind of waves show, we have tried to define a kind of discontinuity, that it's not in actual physical discontinuity, but we say that some kind of rock structure or chemical structure of the rocks is changing at that particular point, right? So some kind of these discontinuities have been given to you over here. Have a look over here. First one is the conoid discontinuity, and more or less these discontinuities may be matching with the physical division that you have made. For example, we have already mentioned that your core can be divided into inner core and outer core. So the this discontinuity between the inner and outer core, we call it as a Lehman discontinuity. As you move up, as you know, you are having a one more division that we have already discussed, that is the barysphere or mesosphere, or you can say core and the this mantle portion. Then the this seismic discontinuity between the core, this core that is outer core, and the lower mantle, we call it as a Guttenberg discontinuity. Then as we move up, we have again defined lower mantle and upper mantle. So this is the upper mantle, you know, this one, and lower mantle, the discontinuity between seismic discontinuity between the lower and upper mantle, we call it a rapid discontinuity. And the discontinuity between the crust and the mantle yahan se start hota hai, as you know, the discontinuity between the crust and the mantle is called as Moho discontinuity. So these all four discontinuities, or Mohorovic we bol dete hain, Mohorovic, this is the name of the person who mentioned this. So these particular discontinuities are more or less also matching with our whatever this division we have done. But in addition to it, one more discontinuity we can mention is called as Conrad discontinuity, right? This discontinuity is basically within the crust. Crust ko bhi further jo hai, based upon the seismic activity, seismic analysis, we find some kind of that particular difference in those waves and all that. So we have again divided that particular discontinuity within this crust ko humne do part mein divide kiya hai. We call it as upper crust and lower crust based upon this seismic activity, and this discontinuity somewhere, this is called as Conrad discontinuity. So exam point of view say it's important for you to remember their names and sequence, aapko pata honi chahiye. You can start from top to bottom, and straightforward ask question can be framed from here. Now, since we have an overall idea of the earth internal structure, now we can move to discuss the how these processes, internal processes, will lead to the formation of different kinds of landforms on the surface of the earth. Let us now discuss the reason for the formation of the landforms on the surface of the earth because of the internal processes. And to explain that, basically different investigators, different theorists or scientists have tried to explain those things. As of now, the most credible, you can say the most trustworthy, or you can just most acceptable theory that can explain, or as of now we have accepted that this could be the possible reason, is called as the plate tectonics theory. Right. So this theory helps us in understanding the mechanism that helps in the formation of the landform on the surface of the earth. Before that, just understand the basic of this. What does this theory says? Right. So this theory says that the earth crust is made up of seven major and some minor plates. Basically, this theory says ki jo pura surface of the earth, if you can just have a look on this particular earth globe as a globe, the whole of the crust and the area below, that is the portion below it, that is the asthenosphere, you can more appropriately you can say the crust and the asthenosphere across the globe can be divided into different plates. That is why the name came as plate tectonics theory. That means whole of that crust, including that your asthenosphere, that is asthenosphere, can be divided into different plates. So many number of plates have been identified, but the seven major plates are there, right, as per this theory. So you should factor information, you should keep in mind that as per plate tectonics theory, how many major plates are there on the surface of the earth, right? So these are some of the major plates that you can have. Look over here. So on this particular map, you can just note down this. For example, this is the Eurasian plate. Eurasian plate, that means this plate, basically this is the same plate which is shown over here. Over here you can just have a look. That is Asia and Eurasian mean Europe plus Asia combined together. So this whole of this portion, Europe and Asia. So this portion, that means this particular plate, that is Eurasian plate. Then you can just North American plate, you're having South American plate, you can just have. Then you're having Pacific plate, that is whole of the Pacific Ocean almost. Then you're having African plate over here. Then you're having India, the part of which plate is called as the Indo-Australian plate, Indian and Australian plate, we can combine together. And then you're having one more plate, that is the Antarctic plate. So combined together, we are having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7 plates total. So same, you can have a look over here. So earth crust, jo hai, humne kya ki, we have divided into 7 major plates and many minor plates. This is what this theory says. Now, this theory says that all these plates are basically interacting. These are the boundary of these plates basically. And all these plates are interacting with each other in these particular areas. Jahan par wo, in their boundaries. So all these plates are interacting with each other at the boundaries, and these interactions are basically leading to the formation of the major kind of landforms on the surface of the earth. Now wo interaction kaise hogi, how that interaction takes place, that we are going to study next. And also we are going to see what is the energy, from where that energy is coming, and therefore which is helping these plates to interact. Interaction ka matlab ye hai ki these plates are in motion, as simple as that. Just imagine ki ye theory bolti hai ki puri jo jitni plates hain, these plates pehle identify ki ye itni plates hain, and all these plates are in constant motion, but that motion is very very slow, right? And since they are moving relative to each other, therefore they are interacting with each other in these boundaries. Ek dusre se interact kar rahi hain. And these interactions, what are those different kinds of interaction that we'll study? But these interactions are leading to the different generation of the different kinds of landforms. Okay. So before that, just see this paragraph and then we can move on to see the different interactions. Just the source of heat. Now, point is, jaise maine kaha ki plates, this theory says that these plates are in constant motion. Right. So from where that energy is coming to put these plates into motion? And obviously this energy can come from within itself, inside the earth. So inside the earth, se wo energy kahan se aa rahi hai? As you may have like studied or heard that the earth, see, that was very hot as such. Initial, jo, it was a very hot, and then slowly started cooling, and over a period of time, jo earth ki crust and the top surface of the earth, that got cooled over a period of time, and then now it is in the solid hard surface ki form mein hai. But the inner portion inside of the earth, it is still in a very heated form. And as you know, as you go deep inside towards the center of this earth, the temperature goes on increasing significantly. So basically this heat inside the earth tries to find the expression. Conduction ke through jo hai bahar nikalna chahti hai. Conduction and maybe internally some kind of convection may be taking place also. But anyway, this kind of heat which is already there inside the earth, they're trying to find the expression, it tries to comes out. And this is the one of the major source of kind of you can say energy, which tries to apply the force on these particular plates and therefore set these plates into motion. Okay, in addition to it, it is also said that there are some kind of radioactive elements that may exist within the mantle and also in the crust, that they, after the disintegration of those elements, they are leading to the what, this generation of the heat, and therefore that heat energy is basically trying to kind of exert a force on the plates, and this will try to find the expression and therefore put them into motion. Just have a look over here, then I think we can proceed further. Source of heat that drives the plate tectonics, plates ko movement pe jo subject karta hai, is the primordial heat left over from the planet's formation, as well as, so one is primordial purani, that means from the very beginning when it started cooling, and then as well as radioactive decay of these, of the, you already know, like these are the radioactive elements, in ke radioactive decay se bhi kuch kind of energy jo hai wo generate ho rahi hai, right? Now see, I had also mentioned to you asthenosphere. Zone of Earth's mantle lying beneath the lithosphere is believed to be much hotter and more fluid than the lithosphere. हमने बात ऑलरेडी डिस्कस किया है कि लिथोस्फीयर क्या है, दैट इज हाईली विस्कस इन नेचर एंड मच हॉटर. द एस्थेनोस्फीयर एक्सटेंड्स फ्रॉम अबाउट रफली, ये आपको आइडिया होना चाहिए, फैक्चुअल इन्फॉर्मेशन है, 100 किलोमीटर टू अबाउट 700 किलोमीटर बिलो द अर्थ सरफेस. नाउ सो अब होता क्या है, व्हाट हैपेंस इज सी हीट फ्रॉम द डीप विद इन द अर्थ इज थॉट टू कीप द एस्थेनोस्फीयर मैलेबल लुब्रिकेटिंग द अंडर साइड ऑफ द अर्थ टेक्टोनिक प्लेट्स एंड अलाउइंग देम टू मूव. ये जस्ट इस सेंटेंस को समझते हैं. I think pictorially this will explain you everything. In a highly idealized way, you are having this, let us say, Earth ka jo, let's man lete hai, this is the what lithosphere. And we said beneath the lithosphere, you are having somewhere here what? You are having this asthenosphere. And asthenosphere jo hai, wo you already said that because you are already having a heat, it is in a highly viscous fluid, highly viscous state mein hai ye, right? That means it can plastically deform easily compared to the this crust portion and the lithosphere portion as well as the portion below this particular portion, right? Now what is happening is we are saying that energy from, as you know, temperature goes on increasing, so this energy tries to find expression, right? So ye jo energy hai wo kya karti hai, it sets the convection currents, or you can say kind of yahan par kya hogi, it's a kind of upwelling ka matlab upward movement, something that way. So yahan se kya hoga, because जो हीट है ट्राई टू फाइंड द एक्सप्रेशन, ये क्या करेगा, इट विल ट्राई टू मेल्ट दिस पोर्शन एंड देयरफॉर जो मोल्टन स्टेट में मटेरियल है, द मटेरियल विच इज इन अ मोल्टन स्टेट विच वी कॉल्ड एज मैग्मा, दैट ट्राइज टू कम्स अपवर्ड, राइट? तो वन इज द प्राइमोडियल ओल्ड जो हीट है विच इज ऑलरेडी एग्जिस्टिंग ओवर देयर, एंड द एडिशनल हीट दैट यू विल ट्राई टू विल गेट फ्रॉम दैट पर्टिकुलर डिसइंटीग्रेशन ऑफ रेडियोएक्टिव एलिमेंट्स, मे बी इन द क्रस्ट, मे बी लिथोस्फीयर एज वेल एज internally also that exists. So this energy basically kya karti hai, this sets the convection currents, ye upward jo hai move aana chahti hai, it try to find expression outside. Now when it tries to find expression outside to kya karti hai, it exerts the force, aur jaise ab upwelling ho rahi hai to keh raha hai ye jo, but dhyan rahe this whole process is very very slow process. So slowly upward coming out, then this is exerting force, slowly exerting force, and some portion of it will get diverted this way, and therefore it will set a kind of convection current cell bana dega, but at the same time, but you see over here, it will try to exert a force on that particular surface above. Now the surface above will get fractured, ye fracture ho jayega. Once it gets fractured, then obviously this will set this particular plate in movement. Obviously is case mein, in this particular case, if you see, when you will exert the force, then obviously kya hoga, let us say this plate will break over here. ब्रेक मूव करेगी तो ब्रेक होगी तो क्या होगा, इट विल मूव दिस वे. अब ये जो प्रोसेस है, सिंस दिस प्रोसेस इज वेरी स्लो प्रोसेस, स्लोली क्या होगा, यहां से मैग्मा क्या होगा, दैट विल कीप एक्सर्टिंग द फोर्स, इट विल फ्रैक्चर ओवर हियर, मैग्मा विल कम आउटसाइड, एंड मैग्मा जब से ऊपर आएगा, जैसे इट विल सेटल, तो क्या होगा, इस प्लेट को जैसे मूवमेंट होगी वहां सेटल हो जाएगा, व्हेन इट विल कूल डाउन, दैट इट हैज ऑलरेडी मूव्ड अ लिटिल बिट. Same way, in the next cycle, when again the magma will come out, it will push it this way. When it will push it this way, some movement took place and the magma will settle. Then it will cool down. So, usko gap ko bharega and dwara halki si movement hogi. That means this process continues, and as of now also it is happening, and this will continue to happen, right? So this is the meaning in future also. So that is how the basically process takes place. So basically, kya hai ki jo energy hai that tries to find expression, and this basically applies the force on the plates, and this sets these plates into motion. So this is not in one location, that is happening in the multiple locations, and that is why it is happening in multiple locations across the globe. That is why those fractures exist on the different, on the surface of the earth, and based upon that we have identified the major plates. So this is what the plate tectonics theory says, that how that particular this motion basically that take place of the earth surface. Now let me just read it out to you again. Heat from the deep within the earth thought to keep the asthenosphere malleable. Malleable means ductile, very ductile. Lubricating the undersides of the earth's tectonic plates, right? And therefore allowing them to move. Obviously, नीचे वाला portion little fluid है, तो वो क्या करेगा? उसको lubricating, इस term use, lubricating का मतलब ये है कि it's a kind of a semi-liquid, semi-solid type of thing, highly viscous kind of thing. So which is acting, that means moving relative to that particular crust portion, below the crust portion or below that particular lithosphere portion, right? And when it exerts the force, then obviously movement comes. Convection currents, ye term aapko pata hona chahiye, convection currents kya hai, right? Convection currents generated within the asthenosphere push the magma upward. ये current ही है. For example, जो convection current है, that is this movement of that particular highly viscous material upward. That is the convection current, right? And therefore, convection currents generated within the asthenosphere push the magma upward through the volcanic vents and spreading the centers create a new crust, right? So as I explained you, so जैसे it will try to come up, then obviously नई crust कैसे formation होगी? It will come out, then it will settle over here. This has already moved, so नई crust formation. So that will become the part of new crust. So this way you can say that whole of that particular process continues. अब हम क्या करते हैं? We will try to see बेसिक प्रोसेस ये रहेगी एंड एज आई टोल्ड यू दैट इज हैपनिंग एट द मल्टीपल लोकेशन अक्रॉस द ग्लोब. बेस अपॉन देन वी हैव आइडेंटिफाइड दिस एनर्जी ने जो एक्सप्रेशन फाइंड आउट करनी है बट हाउ दोज प्लेट्स विल मूव राइट दैट विल डिसाइड अ काइंड ऑफ पर्टिकुलर काइंड ऑफ लैंडफॉर्म दैट विल डेवलप ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ द अर्थ. नाउ दीज आर द थ्री प्रोमिनेंट टाइप्स ऑफ प्लेट मूवमेंट्स दैट आर टेकिंग प्लेस बिकॉज ऑफ दिस एनर्जी राइट दोज कन्वेक्शन करंट्स. So these plates, one is we called it as a first I will take is divergent boundary. Divergent boundary ka matlab hai ki those plates are moving away from each other, right? So moving from away from each other, matlab, as we said, the convection currents are coming, then they are exerting the force, they will break that plate and therefore break will go away. So we call it as a divergent boundary interaction. That means on those particular boundary plates are getting diverged. Then another kind of movement that can take place because of that energy is called as convergent boundary. That means two plates are coming towards each other. Convergent. Transform boundary. That means two plates are moving relative to each other this way. Right. So they are not diverging. They are not converging, but they are moving across this way. So we call it as a transform boundary. So basically, depending upon what kind of interaction is taking place, different kinds of landforms will be formed. Okay. So let's first see this. Ye humne already jo concept explain kiya tha, that is the same thing over here. So divergent, as I said, that the magma is trying to come out and therefore the crust will try to move away. Now, when this happened, then obviously because somewhere when this will move away, so somewhere down the line you need to have the another plate also, right? Uske sath wo kya karegi? Interact karegi. Just think of this way. Let us say you are having over here, let us say I am taking this as a reference, just a minute. Okay, so let us say if it is diverging this way, right? Arrow you can just have, these are diverging over here. So when this is diverging, then obviously we are having another plate over here. So ye kya hogi? This plate, which is diverging from each other, so ye will interact karegi, dusri jagah interact karegi, right? So that means at one location, if it is diverging, then ho sakta hai at the different location, it may be converging. For example, let us say you are having this plate. ये जो प्लेट है आपकी ये प्लेट है. Same way you are having another plate over here. Now what happened is यहां से जो क्या हुआ? Divergence हुआ, diverge, and when it moved this way, then you are having another plate over here. So when it moved this way, then obviously it will interact with over here. They will come together over here. So yahan par jo interaction ban jayegi, wo kya ho jayegi? That will become as a convergent boundary interaction. See, this yahan par kya ho raha hai? It is moving towards this. So yahan par interaction kya ho jayegi? Convergent. So in one side, when you are having a divergent boundary interaction, then on the other side, somewhere it is going to produce another kind of interaction. So that you can find out from here, right? So just have a look. So mostly divergent boundary interaction you are going to find on the ocean floor pe aapko jyada kar milegi ye ki jo ocean flows hain mid wahan par jo hai this kind of interaction is taking place. Just see mid oceanic ridges particularly ya is yahan se bhi dekh sakte hain. For example this one aur yahan par. So ye mostly in the oceans ke floor ke niche, within the oceans, that kind of interaction is taking place. Just have a look over here. Have a look over here. This is the constructive plate boundary. Ye wala portion. Second, constructive plate boundary ka matlab hai ki नई प्लेट्स की जो है वो क्या हो रही है? जनरेशन हो रही है, कंस्ट्रक्ट हो रही है. न्यू प्लेट इज गेटिंग जनरेटेड. नाउ वो कब जनरेट होगी? लेट अस से मैग्मा इज ट्राइंग टू कम आउट, तो ऑब्वियसली क्या होगा? ये डाइवर्ज करेगा. When it will diverge, the middle portion यहाँ पर क्या होगा? Magma will settle and therefore new crust will be formed. Same way यहाँ पर भी वही है. So ये जो portion जो आपको दिख रहा है यहाँ पर, this is the portion of what? Constructive plate boundaries. And most of these constructive plate boundaries, if you will see, they are in the oceans. See this, right? So that means they are leading to the formation of new crust. That is why constructive plate boundaries. Now, same way. Somewhere, as I told you, it is going to produce. So these are the similarly like pictorially you can just see over here. अच्छा इसमें एक example I can quote you over here. I think which is very prominent over here is in some cases it may happen that this kind of interaction, that is a divergent kind of interaction, may lead to, for example, जैसे magma ऊपर आया, magma went up, right? Depending upon what is the strength of that magma. It went up, right, and then it fell like this way and it got settled over here. So if this way it happened, then obviously it may happen that this kind of a mountain, volcanic mountain ridge tayar ho gaya. Yahan to aap front se dekh rahe ho, but if you see along the length, whole of that length, that ek mountain chain under the oceans may get formed, right? So ek to ho gaya ki aapka ridge formation hogi usme, right? Kind of mountain formation hogi, because magma is coming out with a high force, and therefore when it falls, then it is going to settle over there, cools down, and therefore jo cool down ho gaya, obviously kya ho gaya? Kind of mountain ban gayi, right? In some cases it may happen that if that force is not too large, but if force is sufficient enough just to break those, then and therefore kind of rift, kind of depression it is able to create, then along the whole length, if it is able to create that depression in some areas, then that kind of zone area we call that as a rift zone या valley, rift valley बोल देते हैं. Rift क्या हुआ? जो plate as a force acted on those plates, that plate is breaking down and therefore moving, and therefore depression is getting created, and magma जो उसके base पे जो है वो magma got settled in its that particular valley, right? And then got cooled away, right? That is how you have to think. So इसके दो एग्जांपल्स हैं जो हम ले सकते हैं, प्रोमिनेंट एग्जांपल फ्रॉम एग्जाम पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. ये जो इफ आई आस्क यू विच ओशन इज दिस, यू ऑलरेडी नो दिस इज द अटलांटिक ओशन. यहां पर जो फॉर्मेशन है, बेसिकली द फॉर्मेशन इज ऑफ रिज, मैग्मा इज कमिंग आउट. ये जो पूरा पूरा जो ये जो रिज है, इसको बोलते हैं मिड अटलांटिक रिज, मिड अटलांटिक रिज, RIDGE, ridge मतलब kind of mountain hill, right? So किससे form हुआ ये? Because divergent boundary interaction is taking place, moving away. तो magma जो बाहर आ रहा, that is getting formed in the form of a ridge, volcanic mountain बन गई पूरी पूरी. But this whole of the volcanic mountain, as you know, this is Atlantic Ocean, उसके अंदर ही है, नीचे ही है, right? So this is one example that you need to remember. And another example of this divergent boundary interaction is here, Africa. ये, if you just see this dotted line. इसको बोलते हैं हम ईस्ट अफ्रीकन रिफ्ट वैली, राइट? हियर इफ यू कैन जस्ट हैव अ लुक, दिस इज अ लैंडमास. तो ये जो लैंडमास है, यहां पर क्या हुआ, नीचे से फोर्स लग रही है, वो उस फोर्स के कारण जो है प्लेट्स दे आर मूविंग अवे ओवर हियर, एंड देयरफॉर इट हैज क्रिएटेड अ डिप्रेशन कॉल्ड एज रिफ्ट अलोंग होल ऑफ दिस लाइन. तो इट मे हैपन दैट ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम, मिलियंस ऑफ ईयर लेटर, दिस पर्टिकुलरली द ईस्टर्न पोर्शन ऑफ अफ्रीका मे मूव अवे, एंड दिस पोर्शन मे मूव अवे फ्रॉम दिस वे. And हो सकता है ये बीच वाले पोर्शन में, as you know, you're having ocean, ocean water बीच में चला जाएगा, and therefore this land mass may get separated in the coming many years or millions of years later, right? So this is again the interaction. तो आपसे question इस तरीके से पूछा जा सकता है कि mid Atlantic जो region है, या ridge है, mid Atlantic की ridge जो है, that is what kind of interaction से हो रहा है. तो you are going to say this is because of the कंस्ट्रक्टिव बोल सकते हो, क्योंकि नई 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 वो बोल रहे हो कंस्ट्रक्टिव प्लेट बाउंड्री इंटरेक्शन, और यू कैन डाइवर्जेंट बाउंड्री इंटरेक्शन. सेम वे रिफ्ट वैली, ईस्ट अफ्रीकन रिफ्ट वैली इज बिकॉज ऑफ इट, दैट इज अ डाइवर्जेंट बाउंड्री इंटरेक्शन. ओके, जस्ट हैव अ लुक नाउ. ये तो ये जो रिफ्ट वैली जोन मैंने शो किया था, यहां पर आपका जो बीच में हो रहा है, दिस इज दिस अगेन सेम फिगर, यू कैन जस्ट हैव अ लुक ओवर हियर, बिकॉज यहां पर मिड ओशनिक रिज, ये जो रिज है ये मिड ओशन, ओशन के बीच में जो रिजेस हैं वो ये शो किए गए हैं बिकॉज ऑफ डाइवर्जेंट interactions. Now, ये same thing I have already explained you, the eastern portion of the Africa, particularly the, इसको बोलते हैं हम African horn, right? ये वाला portion है, this is the African horn बोलते हैं इसको, horn की shape में है ये, African horn. So, combined together this portion, ये यहां से क्या हो रहा है, यहाँ पर लेक्स भी है, यू आर हैविंग मेनी लेक्स ओवर हियर ऑल्सो, सो दिस पोर्शन इज गेटिंग रिफ्टेड अवे, राइट, तो एक काइंड ऑफ डिप्रेशन क्रिएट हो रही है, एंड एज आई टोल्ड यू, तो यहाँ पर क्या हो रहा है, डाइवर्जेंट बाउंड्री इंटरेक्शन इज टेकिंग प्लेस ओवर हियर ऑल्सो. नाउ नेक्स्ट टाइप ऑफ इंटरेक्शन एज आई टोल्ड यू कुड बी द कन्वर्जेंट, तो एक प्लेस पे लेट अस से क्या हुआ, यहां पर हेयर यू आर हैविंग द डाइवर्जेंट एंड as it is moving away, then another it is going to interact with another plate. So, yahan par kya hoga? When they will come with each other, then they are colliding with each other. So, isko bolte hain convergent boundary interaction. So, when they are going to collide with each other, right? They are converging toward each other. So, hoga kya? Us case mein the denser plate, the plate which is having higher density, is going to move downward. Crush honge, obviously kya hoga? When you push it, obviously it is going to have a crushing like this. But at the same time, since this density, one of the plate is going to have a higher density, it is going to move up, move down. So it is going to move down, it is going to be lifted up. So the mountain chains, many of the mountain chains, for example, Himalayas also, they have been formed because of this convergent boundary interaction in which one plate goes down, the other gets lifted up, right? So just have a look now. Yeah. So depending upon where it is happening, this particular kind of interaction may happen with the oceanic plate and continent plate ke beech ho sakti hai, ya continent continent plate ho sakti hai, oceanic oceanic plate ho sakti hai, that location could be. So what will happen is, this case mein if you just see, oceanic plate is will be denser than this continental plate, that means landmass, right? So it is going down and therefore it will get lifted up. So kind of visualization you can have, when these two are interacting with each other, obviously they will get deformed, right? And therefore kind of this structure will be form. Just have a look over here, right? So one portion is going down, the other portion is getting lifted up. One portion is going, this case mein yahan se ja raha hai, going down, lifted up. This kind of visualization you can have ideally. So iska matlab ye hua ki if wherever you're going to have the convergent boundary interaction, you're going to have a what? Ek jagah trench formation ho sakti hai. So that is a landform formation. हमने कहा कि we are going to have a different kinds of landform. तो वो जो trench है, गड्ढा है, खाई है, of बहुत ज़्यादा particular length की, उसको हमने trench बोल दिया. For example, if you just see, so this could be a trench along its length. ये यहाँ पर, right? Just have a look. So this could be a trench. So when one is subducting, the other one is getting lifted. तो यहाँ पर क्या हो सकता? Depression create हो जाए. यहाँ पर भी same situation हो सकती है आपकी यहाँ जैसे. Right. So, what kind of landforms it is creating? One is a trench that it is creating along the length in many kilometers. And the other one is, because it got folded, these particular areas got folded, it has led to the formation of the mountains. So, this is a mountain formation. A portion jo hai, wo lift bhi ho jayega. It will get lifted up also. So, that is how these landforms are formed. So, iska ek example dena hai in terms of like इंडिया कॉन्टेक्स में वी कैन स्टडी. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इस केस में इंडो ऑस्ट्रेलियन प्लेट इज मूविंग दिस वे एंड यूरेशियन प्लेट इज कमिंग दिस वे, दे आर कमिंग हेड टू हेड. सो वेन दे आर कमिंग हेड टू हेड, जस्ट हैव अ लुक ओवर हियर इफ यू वॉन्ट टू सी. सी हाउ द हिमालयस हैव बीन फॉर्म, जस्ट हैव अ लुक ओवर हियर. सो हियर यू आर हैविंग ए इंडो ऑस्ट्रेलियन प्लेट विच इज रफली मूविंग नॉर्थवर्ड्स. And this is moving southwards this way, Eurasian, right? So when they are coming together, yahan par jo hai wo kya hai, Himalayas have been formed, right? So Indian plate jo hai wo denser, and then it is getting subducted. Now let's see that particular figure. See this one, right? So this is when they are interacting over here. As you can just see, Indian Australian plate denser, it is going down. And this portion Eurasian plate, that is the thing. Yahan par folding hui, got folded, and they got lifted out. So Himalayas formation hui. So yahan par trench, yahan par you're having this Himalayas. And then here, because this portion as it is got lifted away from it. So this is Tibetan plateau. As you know, Tibetan plateau is the highest plateau in the world. So ye kya hai? Ye iske interaction ke kaan, jo it got lifted up, and now it is stable mass, but at a height, right? Away from the toward, that means this is a part of China, as you know, right? So same thing has been represented over here. So this is the landform, kind of landform that could be created. Yahan par main dobara explain karunga. Yahan par trench aapko dikh nahi rahi hai, that I will explain again in the last slide. And another kind of that is interaction that can take place is called as transform boundary movement. Now see, the example that I am going to quote is of US and that particular plate. Just have a look. As I told you, in case of transform boundary movement, two plates will be moving along with each other right? The difference only is that one plate will be moving faster than the other plate. So obviously, whenever you are having one plate moving faster than each other, so obviously what is going to happen? It is going to create a certain kind of, it is going to deform it, or so that way a new kind of landform may be generated, right? One is moving, both are moving, but one is moving faster than. So that kind of interaction, if it is taking place, we call it as a this. Just see, this plate, North American plate, is moving this way. And roughly, Pacific plate is also moving this way. The difference is only in the form of their velocities, and here you're going to have a landforms generated because of this kind of transform boundary moment. So let me just show you that example over there. From there you can get the idea. Yeah. So this is the actual visible kind of landforms that has generated because of this interaction, and see the location in USA. Basically, this is the California state of USA, and here you are having, I hope you have heard about these Los Angeles, San Francisco kind of cities over there. So they fall under this particular, we call it as a San Andreas fault. Very popular name is San Andreas fault. And this fault has been created, this fault has been created because of, so you may be asked the simple, San Andreas fault has been created because of what kind of interaction? Then you're going to say transform boundary interaction between these two, which plates? Again, plates ka pata honi chahiye, North American, American plate and the Pacific plate. Now, ye jo Pacific plate hai, it is moving faster, whereas this particular plate is moving slower. And therefore, it has created a certain kind of structure. Or you can say, obviously, the material level distorts at that particular location. So this is another kind of interaction. So these are the three major kind of interaction that you can say that are going to lead to the formation of different kinds of landforms. Aapko ye example kuch hai, you should know the kind of examples from where that energy came, what the energy did, and what are those different kinds of interactions that are taking place. Now, let me just give you a brief. The plate tectonics theory thi, wo hum basically the present existing state hai, uske upar explain karne mein chalenge. But how that basically this plate tectonics theory explained the generation from the very beginning. See, as of now, we discussed that, okay, you're going to have seven plates and all that. But ye theory ye bolti hai, ki see, initially, जो जितना भी लैंड मास था, आज की डेट में यू आर हैविंग डिफरेंट कॉन्टिनेंट्स एंड ऑल दैट, दे वर कंबाइंड टुगेदर, एक ही लोकेशन पे थे ऑल दोस कॉन्टिनेंट्स, वर नॉट सेपरेटेड बट इट वाज अ सिंगल लैंड मास. यहां पर विक्टोरिया इट हैज बीन गिवन एज ए सेपरेट, बट दिस होल ऑफ दैट लैंड मास वाज ओनली एट वन लोकेशन. ओके, तो एक ही लोकेशन पे था एंड द रिमेनिंग पोर्शन वॉज ओशियन ऑब्वियसली. सो सी, जो ये होल ऑफ दिस लैंड मास विच वॉज एट ओनली वन लोकेशन, इट वॉज गिवन ए नेम कॉल्ड एज पेंजिया. So, आपको एक नाम पता होना चाहिए, पेंजिया. पेंजिया क्या था? यू शुड बी वेरी क्लियर अबाउट इट. तो पेंजिया वाज द होल ऑफ द लैंड मास, राइट, विच वाज कंबाइंड टुगेदर, ऑल द कॉन्टिनेंट्स कंबाइंड टुगेदर विच वर एट ए सिंगल लोकेशन, उसको हमने नाम दे दिया था पेंजिया. एंड द ओशियन पार्ट था, वी गेव इट ए नेम कॉल्ड एज पैसिफिक ओशियन, बोलो या उसको पेंथलासा नाम दिया था हमने, राइट. तो सेकंड नेम यू शुड नो, पेंथलासा. नाउ व्हाट हैपेंड, व्हाट थ्योरी सेज ऑन द सिमिलर लाइंस एज वी डिस्कस, व्हाट हैपेंड, द दिस एनर्जी फ्रॉम बीनीथ, what that energy did, this energy was trying to find an expression, and therefore usne kiya is puri jo the crust thi ya jo lithosphere part tha which was combined together, usko it broke it down in different kind of continents jo aaj ki date mein dikhte hain aap. So this way ye aapka jo hai us waqt when force was exerted, then it got broken, that particular pangea was broken into these particular different continents, right? And then hua kya, slowly over a period of time in millions of years, these land masses, separated land masses, got shifted away. Dheere dheere shift hote gaye, drifting bolte hum. So drift hote gaye, and now they are in the present locations, and still they are in constant motion. And if you will come maybe like millions of years later, then the location where you're finding India, maybe you not find here, it may have moved a little bit, right? So that is how you have to think of. So and from the exam point of view, again you have to see, we will say factual information, Pangaea, whole of the landmass, uska jo north portion tha, we called it as a Laurasia, it was called Laurasia, and the southern portion was called as Gondwanaland, and we were the part of what, see the India is over here, so we were the part of what, Pangaea mein, we were the part of Gondwanaland, right? That is how it says. So theory says single landmass Pangaea, northern portion you are having Glacier, southern portion Gondwana land. Energy broke it down, that had that particular energy broke that particular landmass into many continents, and those continents drifted away over a period of time, and therefore they are now at the present location, right? A over a period of time, like very old to new one, right? See, India was over here, something very like India is moving northward, and this Eurasian plate was moving this way, roughly southward. So if as you just see over here, India is moving northwards. India is moving northwards. This is moving roughly southwards. So northward, roughly southward. And now, then finally, when India was moving northward, this was roughly moving southward. यहाँ पर क्या हुआ? Himalayas में आपकी जो interaction हुई, and this interaction was convergent. And convergent boundary interaction हुई. So as I explained you, what happened over there, right? So let us see these some of these points, and then we'll wrap it up. So Pangaea consisted of what? Loresh, ek aur alternate name tha that you should know. That is a, we call it as a Angara land, or we call it as a Laurasia, northern portion, and Gondwana land, southern portion. Factual information. India was part of what? Gondwana land, southern portion ka part tha. Convection current split in the crust Pangaea into number of pieces that I discussed to you. Convection current is inside heat that split it, that this particular whole of that Pangaea into different this. Indian land was drifted northwards. Ye bhi pata hona chahiye aapko, India around kis taraf drift hua, separated from Gondwana land. Gondwana land as a total humne kaha, but it got shifted over northwards and it got separated from Gondwana. This resulted in the collision of Indian plate. Indian plate drifted northwards, much larger Eurasian plate which is moving southward. Already explained to you. Then thus, the sedimentary rocks which are accumulated in the geosynclinotathesis are folded to form the mountain system of Eastern. This last line I will explain you, as I explained you. So India was, as I said, this peninsular India was moving this way, and this portion was coming this. So when, since Indian plates, Indian Australian plates is denser, so what happened basically? This, if you see, Indian plate, when this came in contact with this, it got subducted. So when it got subducted over here, this got lifted, and it is not a simple like subduction. It's simply because it folded also, exerted a force, and obviously then mountains were formed. This whole of this mountain chain was formed over here. But at the same time, in between क्या हुआ? Because it was getting subducted, यहाँ पर क्या हुआ? Trench formation होगी. Trench मतलब kind of ये पूरी जो आज आप Indo-Gangetic plains देखते हो आप, right? All this northern portion plain area, that is basically क्या था? That was a geosyncline. जिसको क्या हुआ? Because when it was getting drifted away, you just see, when it was getting drifted away, it is saying completely the geosyncline. Geosyncline का मतलब वही वो जो trench formation हुई, वो जो trench formation थी, basically it was filled up with sea, water था बीच में, that got drifted away, and then it was filled up with the sediments. जो जितने भी आपका जो rivers ने फिर क्या sediments लाए, they got deposited over here. So a whole of this particular portion basically, if you just see, ये जो पूरा portion था जो कि geosyncline था, because of the sediments brought by the river, it got deposited over. That is why it is whole of this particular region, as you know, this is a, what is fertile, right? And at present, you are having all of this area as a plain area, and deformation ke baad, you are having like Himalayas got formed, and then as I mentioned to you, that is Tibetan plateau got lifted up, right? And got formed. So this is basically how these landforms form. So not only India context, definitely we are going to talk, but other kind of across the world also such kind of interactions took place, which led to the formation of either rift valleys, or either formation of these particular, let us say, these mountains, or maybe plateaus, right? So this is what you need to know in this case. And in the next video, I'm going to discuss about that. Since we were talking about the major landform formation, kaise hui, in the next video, we're going to talk about the across the world, which are the different types of major mountains, what kind of mountains are those, plateaus bane aapke, kis tarah ke hain. And in Indian context also, like this peninsular part, we have not discussed. We are also going to discuss different landforms we are going to discuss. So you need to have a little idea. Ye jo aapki continental drift theory hai, and different kinds of interaction that are taking place, uska aapko idea hona chahiye is particular topic mein. Okay. So that is all from my side in this particular topic. And we'll see you with the next topic in the next video. Till then, bye. Thank you.